Morning students, welcome to all who are watching these videos. In this video, I start the chapter functions from the maths 1 year paper. Okay, first we discuss about the definitions. So what is the function? First we want the function definition. So first, what is the function? So before telling about the definition of the function, let us discuss about some definition. The first one is Cartesian product. Okay, listen. So the first definition is Cartesian product. So first I take here two sets A comma B. What is set here? A is equal to ABC. So here first I take one set A is equal to ABC and B is equals to 1, 2. Okay. So now these are the two sets. So first, now I take the Cartesian product. Now Cartesian product of A and B is denoted by A cross B, A into B, but we read it as A cross B. Now what are the values? Just we are taking the all possible ordered pairs. We are taking the all possible ordered pairs which are formed by using these two sets. And first we take the element of the A first and the element of the B second. Okay, see here. The first I take that here A comma 1, element of the first set, element of the second set. Now I take the second ordered pair A comma 2. Okay, A comma first element, A comma second element. Okay, now starts with the B element, that is B comma 1, B comma 2. Understand? B comma 1, B comma 2. Next I take the remaining two ordered pairs, which are C comma 1, C comma 2. Just here we are taking the all possible ordered pairs. Okay, A comma 1, A comma 2, B comma 1, B comma 2, C comma 1, C comma 2. So this is called the Cartesian product. Cartesian product of the sets A comma B, that is denoted by A cross B. Okay, this is the first definition. What is Cartesian product? Means the set of all possible ordered pairs from A to the set, from the set A to the set B. This is the A cross B. Okay, let us see the definition here, the mathematical definition. See the definition all of you here. Let A comma B be two sets, then the set A comma B such that A belongs to A, B belongs to B is called the Cartesian product of A and B, and that is denoted by A cross B. We read it as A cross B. Here we write that A into B, but we read it as A cross B. Okay, now the next definition, relation. Very easy. Relation means any subset of A cross B is called the relation. Okay, for example, I take here one relation. For example, here we have the one Cartesian product. This is the Cartesian product. Now I am taking some values here, A comma 1, A comma 2 only here. Okay, I am taking only two ordered pairs from this entire set. I am taking only A comma 1, A comma 2. Now this is called the relation. Just this is nothing but the subset of the A cross B. The subset of A cross B is called the relation. Okay, now let us see the definition. If A comma B be non-empty sets, then any subset of A cross B is called the relation from A to B. Okay, if we take any relation from A to A, then that is said to be the binary relation. That is, if we take the set itself as two tens, then we tell that is the binary relation. Okay, so this is the Cartesian product, and subset of Cartesian product is called the relation. Okay, now the next definition, function. Now what is the function? Okay, for this here I am taking two sets here. Okay, this is the first set, this is the second set. I am taking here two sets. So 1, 2, 3, suppose this is A, this is B. I am taking two sets here. The first set, in the first set we have the elements 1, 2, 3. Okay, and in the second set we have the elements A, B, C. I am taking two sets here, A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to A, B, C. Okay, now the relation from F, A to B, the relation, we are taking one relation from F, A to B. Suppose, so here I am taking that, suppose 1 is connected to the element A, 2 is connected to the element B, 3 is connected to the element C, then this relation is said to be the function. Okay, that is, every element of A is connected to the unique element of B, that is said to be the function. Okay, so here function means, okay, I am writing the relation 1, see the relation here, F is equals to, so here 1 is connected to A means we take the first ordered pair as 1 comma A, and the second ordered pair as 2 comma B, and the third one is 3 comma C. Okay, this is the function. And I'm telling the second example. See here. So I'm taking another relation here. Okay. FA to B. Here also I'm taking the second relation FA to B. And here also I take the elements of A is equals to 1, 2, 3 and element B is equal to ABC. Okay. Here first I am connecting the first element 1 to the A and second element 2 to the A and third element 3 to the B. Yes, this is also the function. We can tell that this relation is also the function. Why? Because here 1 is connected to A, 2 is connected to A, 3 is connected to B. All elements of A, each and every element of A is connected to the unique element of B. Yes, so this is also the function. This is also, yes, this relation is also the function. And what is this function here? What are the ordered pairs in this function? F is equals to first element is 1 comma A, first ordered pair is 1 comma A, second ordered pair is 2 comma A and third ordered pair is 3 comma B. Here the condition is all elements are connected to the elements of A, but it is not necessary to connect all the elements of B to the elements of A. It is not connected, but this is the element of B, so no problem. So this is a function, okay? This is not the element of A. Here the condition is elements of A are connected to the elements of B. Now see the next example. So here I am taking another example FA to B, okay? So here the elements of A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 2 elements in the second set AB. If suppose 1 is connected to A and 2 is connected to B, this is not the function. Why? Because here 3 is not connected to the element of the B. Okay. This is not connected to the element of B. This is not the function. So this is not a function. This is the function. This is the function. Why? Because all elements of A are connected to the elements of B. But here the element 3 is not connected to the element of B. So this is not the function. Okay. And one more example. Taking the another example FA to B. Okay. So here the elements of A is equal to 1, 2, 3. Suppose and elements of B is equals to A comma B. A comma B comma C. A comma B comma C. If suppose 1 is connected to A, 2 is connected to A and the suppose the element 3 is connected to B comma C, then this is not the function since the element 3 is connected to the two elements of B. Here the condition is element of A is connected to the unique element of B. Here the condition is element of A is connected to the single element of the B, unique element of the B. But here the element B is connected to the two elements. So this is not the function. Understand all of you? Why this is not a function? Since the element 3 is not connected to the element of B, so this is not a function. But here why this is not a function? The element 3 is connected to two elements of the B, so this is not a function. What is the condition? For every element of A is connected to the unique element of B. Every element must connect to the unique element of B. That is the condition. Okay, let us see the definition. Okay, see the definition here. Let A comma B be non-empty sets and F be a relation from A to B. Then for each element A belongs to A, there exists a unique B belongs to B such that A comma B belongs to F. Understand? For every A belongs to A, for every element of the A, there exists unique B belongs to B such that A comma B belongs to F. So this is called the definition of the function. So this is called the function. Okay. It is denoted by FA to B. The function F is denoted by FA to B. This is the function notation. So this is the function that is defined from A to B. And here the first set A is called the domain of the function. The first set A is called the domain of F. And the second set B is called the codomain of F. Okay. This is the domain of F and the name of the B is codomain of F. Now the next definition. Okay, see the next definition. So here again I take one function here. So F is a function that is defined from A to B. I am taking the elements A, 1, 2, 3 are the elements of the set A and A, B, C are the elements of the set B. And suppose 1 is connected to A, 2 is connected to B, 3 is connected to C. So here, what is the F relation? So this is the function. So what is F function here? What is the ordered pairs? The first pair is 1 comma A and the second pair is 2 comma B and the third pair is 3 comma C. Okay, the another notation is, so here A is called the image of 1. Okay. And the notation is F of 1 is equals to A. Here A is called the, this A is called as the image of 1. And this B is called as the image of 2. And the notation is F of 2 is equals to B. F image of 2 or image of 2, that is equals to P. And the next one, this is nothing but the image of 3, that is we take that value as f of 3 is equal to C. Okay, here what is A? Here we tell that this A is the image of 1, this is the image of 2, this is the image of 3. And the another notation is, okay, listen, f of 1 is equals to A, here we have this one, then what is one value? Just write this f to this set, that becomes f inverse. So here 1 is called the pre-image of A. Okay, A is the image of 1 and this 1 is called the pre-image of A. This is the another definition. Okay, so here the names of 1 comma A are, A is called the image of 1 and this 1 is called the pre-image of A. That's all. Okay, so what is the definition here? Image and pre-image. What is the meaning of the image? F A to B is a function and if F of A is equals to B, then B is called the image of A. Okay, F of A is equals to under F or F image, and the element A is called the pre-image or inverse image of B under the function F. Okay, and that is denoted by F inverse of B. That's all. And the last definition, range of the function, range of A. Okay, listen. So here, for example, I take one function here. So this is the f function a to b, that is defined from a to b, and I am taking the elements a is equal to 1, 2, 3 here and b is equal to a, b, c. I am taking the two sets here, a is equal to 1, 2, 3 and the second set b is equal to a, b, c. What is a here? This is called the domain. Already I told this definition. Now a is equal to domain. And what is the name of the b? B is equal to codomain. Now what is the range of the function? That is the given question. If suppose 1 is connected to a, 2 is connected to b, 3 is connected to b. Just I am taking the connections like that. Now here range is equals to, range of f is equal to, range of f means only we take the set of elements which are the set of all collected elements of the set P is called as the range of the function. Understand? Only the connected elements of the set P. What are the connected elements in the set P here? Only here we have two elements which are connected to the elements of A here. So just I take these two elements in one set. This is called the range of F. Okay. What is the meaning of the range here? The set of connected elements of the set B is called as the range of the function and that is denoted by F of A. The another notation of range is F of A. Okay. Here first set is called the domain and second set is called the codomain, and F of A, range of F means just we take the connected elements of the set P only, those are the range of the function. Now let us see the definition. Once see the definition here, if F A to B is a function, then F of A, the set of all F images of the elements in A. F images, these are the images, this is the image of 1, this is the image of 2, this is the image of 3. F images of the function, F images of the elements in A is called the range of the function. Simply directly you can tell that only the connected elements in the set P is called as the range of the function, and that is denoted by the letter F of A. Understand? Okay, these are the definitions, most important and useful definitions of the functions. And in the next class, I start the types of the functions. Okay.